I had a Yelp account where I would just write these crazy reviews for things.
I love it.
They wound up taking my account away. And I don't know why, because I would always give 5-star reviews. They were just rambling. The reviews were just rambling. It had very little to do with the business. Right. And then one day they weren't there. And then last night I was going through my Google Docs, and because I had saved some screenshots of some of the reviews, but I was like, oh my God, I lost pretty much all those reviews. And I was going through my Google Docs and I found that I had like 18 pages. I guess one day I had the forethought to go, you know what, this might get taken down.
Screenshot.
Yeah.
And I copied and pasted them. So if you want, I could read I could do something funny on this.
Yes.
Thing.
Please do.
Let me read one of these Yelp reviews. And let me find.
I feel like a school kid. I need to hear this.
I mean, and I do think that they might be better read. I feel like this is, after reading them, I'm like, oh, these are good. It's funny. I talked about making yourself laugh. I read them last night. Yeah. I was like really laughing at some of these. And I'm like, oh, this is like a Jack Handy book or something almost. Okay, I'll read one. I'm really full of myself tonight. All my, then I was making crank phone calls on stage. I thought I would take it to another level.
People, I can't separate the man from the fiction. It's class.
People said, I've never seen anything
like that. The universe just told Doug to give me those shows, man.
Yeah, no, so I had to seize the moment, of course. I was at a crossroads in my career. I could have either stayed on the bench or stepped up to the plate. And, you know, the rest is history, as you all know. I did 2 fucking dates. I did 2 shows, and I plan to do more maybe someday if somebody forces me to fucking do anything. So let me find. There's...
I just peed myself.
Okay, this bird one. Okay, so there's one for a bird store. Let me do this. I'll do this one first.
Sounds good.
And then maybe I'll do another one, because there is kind of a through line of the guy cheating on his wife and stuff. Okay, Pampered Birds, June 3rd, 2018, 5 stars. Let me start by saying I love birds. I grew up with a parrot named Smokey who knew how to smoke cigarettes. My dad got him from the exotic bird black market back in the 80s. I guess the previous owner taught him how to do that. Everyone loved Smokey, even though he could be a jerk sometimes, but all birds are jerks sometimes. Ask anyone. Smokey spoke some weird language that we couldn't figure out what it was. My mom would drink wine and smoke cigarettes in the kitchen while she danced around the Frank Sinatra records. Smokey would join in and squawk his head off, and my mom would give him cigarettes too. My dad fed Smokey a piece of turkey on Thanksgiving one year, and my mom was laughing so hard she couldn't breathe and knocked a bunch of stuff on the floor. One time, my mom and Smokey were so loud dancing around in the kitchen and blaring that greasy meatball music. That's what my dad called Frank Sinatra's music. My dad went into the garage to sleep in the car. It was winter, and my dad was drunk too, so he turned the car on to stay warm, but he left the car running and died.
Carl, are you too tired to fucking laugh at this stuff?
No, I'm laughing. It's all internal, but it's real. It's just hurt.
Either way, Smokey lived like 20 more years, and my mom is still alive and has since remarried to a guy named Vince. Me and Vince would go to the bar sometimes, and we always look the other way if one of us meets a woman and takes her somewhere to cheat on our wives with. Don't get all high and mighty because Vince is cheating on my mom and I don't tell her. What good would it do? Vince is a man with needs, and my mom doesn't need to know what Vince gets up to at the bars. Same goes for my wife. What I do when I'm out with Vince is my business. Case closed. That's why I came to Pampered Birds to buy my wife. Being a real pain, and I kind of lost water. We got a big fight, and she was crying and everything, and she even took off her wedding ring and threw it. I can't get a divorce, though, because we have kids and I make a lot of money. And my wife, and I'm not giving and I make a lot of money, and I'm not giving her my house, half my stuff, and cutting her a fat check every month. You're crazy if you think she deserves that. She never worked a day in her life. And guys used to just give her stuff, including me, because she used to look good. Only I'm the sucker who married her. Let me tell you, being married to an aging party girl is no picnic. I'll get her a damn cockatoo and some flowers and call it a day. Maybe I could secretly train the bird to peck her in her neck and eat her jugular vein like a worm or whatever. LOL. I'm 100% joking. I'm 100% joking around, so don't get your panties in a bunch over a joke, my dear. Guys make jokes like that all the time. Honestly, she'll probably do herself in by taking a handful of pills at some point. Pampered Birds has some great birds. It's one-stop shopping if you want to buy a bird. You can get a bird, a cage, all sizes, bird seed, decorations, water things, the works. You can walk out of the store with everything you need to be a total bird owner. The staff is knowledgeable about birds, and they're good at recommending cages, perches, and other bird-related items. I rated it 5 stars because you can get everything for your bird there, including a bird. If you don't trust my judgment just because me and my stepdad cheat on our wives together, grow up. I do love my wife, but that's none of your business. That's not what this review is about.
That
was a long one.
Did you write those in one go, just stream of consciousness, or did you take a while on it? Or?
No. Yeah, that's just a... Yeah, you just write the review and get out of there.
You're in the zone writing that stuff.
Just write the review and get on with it.
Yeah.
Metallica. Let me see if there's
the sad thing about it, that there's somebody who's reading that who's not a dumb person but still thinks that's fucking real. You know, somebody will read that and say, holy fucking, go tell all their friends, you got to read this review and fall for it 100%.
They know,
like, Matt,
they know
audience.
they just can't have that kind of fucking behavior on there.
Okay, I'll do one more, and I do really have to go. Okay. Guys, okay. Texting. Oh,
thank you very much, Brendon.
Yeah.
Well, let me say, I mean, this is for me. At least it's something funny.
Oh, my God. I just
Okay, so there's one speed dating. There's a speed dating thing. And then there's... Let me do the speed dating thing. I won't... I feel like there's probably... I mean, there's a few good ones. It's 18 pages long. Okay, well, let me... I mean, it's big. It's probably not 18 pages if you printed it. Okay, speed LA dating from 2019. Removed by Yelp, it says. My wife had to go out of town because her mother passed away recently. I don't want to speak ill of the dead, but good riddance. Since my wife's sister is a useless hippy-dippy moron, my wife had to handle all the funeral arrangements, etc. So she was going to be gone for at least a week. I decided to check out Speed LA Dating to meet someone to have a fling with and possibly get some mud for my turtle, if you catch my drift. Now, before you get all judgmental on me, let me explain a few things to you. One, I've been with my wife for a long time. Two, she has gained a bunch of weight. Three, we have a don't ask, don't tell policy as far as I'm concerned. Four, variety is the spice of life. Five, it's 2019, so get with the times, Mother Teresa. Everybody cheats. So anyway, I found a coupon online for this dating thing and decided to give it a whirl. I thought it would be a good way to meet a ton of women real fast, maybe even date two ladies in one day. They had the speed dating event at a bar/restaurant, but honestly, it was kind of a sausage party. There were like 15 dudes and only 4 females. I don't want to get all political, but you know how women are always complaining that men make like a dollar more an hour than them or whatever? Well, when it comes to having sex, they could pretty much get it anytime, anywhere, whenever they want. Personally, I'll take a dollar hour or less if I could do that. I speed dated with 4 ladies and got all their numbers, but one of them had her septum pierced, the sleeve tattoo, and she went out to smoke a cigarette at one point. So you know she is 100% DTF and definitely a freak in the sack. So I focused my energy on her. There was a ponytail guy there who was also pursuing her hard as well, which was pretty annoying. But at the end of the night, I realized the bartender at the second bar was putting all our drinks on his tab. So that kind of worked out. He didn't seem to notice. And I got like 5 free vodka Red Bulls, which in LA is like at least $60. No lie. When we left the bar, I didn't really know what my move would be, but she took control and invited both me and the other guy back to her place. Told you she was a freak. We were all pretty blitzed, so I wanted to take an Uber, but she insisted on driving because she didn't want to leave her car. Me and the other guy decided to let her drive because we knew we were in store for a steamy night if we played our cards right. We didn't want to do anything to mess it up. She sideswiped a parked car on Sunset on our way to her place, but luckily nobody saw it, and we made it back to her place in one piece where we had some more drinks, and me and the other guy started kissing her, and no surprise, she was into it. I don't want to get into any graphic detail about what happened next, but we did everything you can imagine, everything, including me and the ponytail guy doing stuff. Overall, I give this place 5 stars because I got exactly what I wanted, and it was cheap because of the coupon and the ponytail guy paying for all my VRBs.
Oh my God.
I'm definitely going to do it again, hopefully with me and 2 chicks next time. I got to do something with, that was great discovering those.
It sounds like so much fun. I wish I had the talent to do that.
You've got to put those out somehow. Record it, stick them out, even voice notes, throw them up somewhere. Book.
Monetize that sucker, man. Just do it. Carl's right. That's just an audio reading of all of them in a nice little audio book.
I feel like it's better as a printed thing. I mean, I think it's more enjoyable to read them, to be honest.
I can see that as well, but hearing it in your voice is also awesome. And that's,
I'm all congested. Yeah, maybe doing like a reading.
I don't know, man.
Yeah.
Like a poetry book. Chapbook. Hilarious. Oh, yeah. My God.
Well, I know you have to go, and we appreciate this time more than I could say. And I know Andy does,
too. Thank you
very
much, Brendon. Awesome, man.
And big hearts get rewarded. So sooner or later, somehow, some way, the universe will pay you back for the generosity.
Thank you for the laughs, Brendon.
Oh, this is fine. Appreciate it. You got to take it up with my sketch writing class.
Okay. You might sign up.
Yeah. Who's next? Yeah.
Who's next? Doug Stanhope. You're opening up for him again tonight.
is he on the line already?
He's not on the line. No. So if you want to hang out till he gets here.
No, I gotta go. I'm already 20 minutes late.
Yeah. He's going to be here any minute, though. But yeah.
All right. I love mine, dog. I love you. I love having the dog be the best friend of my mind.